Hello, and welcome to another episode of the Woman on Fire Entrepreneur Show. And if you haven't known yet, we are actually broadcasting not only on iTunes, but you can jump over to YouTube. So if you go to youtube.com/ Heather Picken, that's spelled P-I-C-K-E-N, you can actually watch us now. I'm waving my hand, which is really exciting. And I'm always on fire and inspired to bring some amazing guests all over the world. And today I have my guest coming all the way from Ireland, which is part of my roots. So that's really exciting. And I want to welcome Mike Pettigrew to our show. So Mike, thank you so much for being my guest today.
My pleasure, Heather. Thanks so much for asking me.
And I love this topic that we're going to be talking about, because being an entrepreneur, as you know, you've got to get your mind aligned to your vision. And a lot of times what happens is if something doesn't go your way, people tend to stop. People tend to not move forward. And I know the topic we're going to be talking about is, you know, the dominant thoughts and our emotions and how they shape our reality. And I think we can kind of, you know, share how that works in a business world, you know, and how we're growing our businesses or not growing our businesses by our dominant thoughts and our emotions. So I was wondering if you could share with our listeners and viewers today a little bit about your story and how you came into doing the work that you do today.
Absolutely. Great question. Well, I started my first business back in 1987. I was originally an electronic engineer. That's what I qualified in. But very quickly, I went into business. And I really like business. I started my first company, as I say, in 1987. That was, would you believe, Office Plants. You know, we had, you know, I grew that company over the next 14 years to become one of the biggest of its kind in the country, in Ireland. And we supplied tropical plants to, you know, hotels, banks, hospitals, offices, and it was a great business. It was fantastic. And I suppose, Heather, when I started business, I had very little self-esteem. I was the kid at school who was never picked for the football or rugby team because I was so useless, or rather, because everybody told me I was useless. And when you keep hearing that you're useless, you become pretty bad at things, you know? So it was almost a self-fulfilling prophecy based on, what would you say, conditioning from my peers. So I had very little self-esteem. And through business, you know, anybody that goes into business has lots of challenges that stretches their lives in different ways. And gradually, I overcame that. I gradually became empowered, gradually. And I mean, I remember one experience particularly where I think it was 4 years into my first business, and my cash flow had been terrible, you know, up and down like a roller coaster. And I really needed to look at this. And I knew the solution to this lay within me. And I discovered, I actually had a series of experiences that showed me that my self-esteem, my self-worth, my self-value was low. And I had to make a decision because I had literally hit a wall. And I owed so much to suppliers and had so little coming in from clients in the next month. I thought I was going to have to close up shop. And it forced me to look at my own self-worth. And I had to make a very hard decision, either double my prices to my clients, double my prices. Now, that was a huge jump, or close up shop. And I think I had about 50 or 60 clients at the time, all corporate clients. And every one of them said, yeah. In fact, many of them said, we thought you were too cheap anyway. So, you know, from that point forward, once I realized my own self-value, my self-worth, then I had no problems about charging higher than average prices from that point forwards. And my wealth grew in direct proportion to my self-esteem and my confidence. Now, that was great. When I sold my company in 2001 to a multinational, I thought I wouldn't have to do normal work again. In fact, I was doing voluntary work most of the time. And when I sold that company, I never thought that what lay ahead, I never had any inkling of what lay ahead, but I trusted the wrong people. I made very bad investments. And just a very few short years later, I lost everything. And I had a wife and a newborn baby. and I had no money to feed them. It was that bad. I can't even begin to describe how frightening that was. And here's me, who had lots of self-confidence, a lot of self-belief. I turned into like a lump of jello. You know, I would drag myself out of bed because there was 1 year. In fact, there was a series of years, but one particular year where we lost $250,000 just in 1 year. And €250,000 is more in dollars. It's more like $300,000. And there was a series of years like that. And when you cannot feed your loved ones, it's just devastating. It's just devastating. If it was me on my own, I could pick up myself. But when you have two people, one just a newborn baby who's totally reliant on you, it was terrible. And I just literally dragged myself out of bed every morning, wanting to vomit with the fear. It was that bad. It was a physical, and it went on a long time. But I made this literal vow to the universe, more than a prayer. I vowed, this will change. I will change it no matter what it takes. I will change this, and I will change it now. And it's amazing when you have a strong intention and you propel it with emotion out into the universe reflects it back in synchronicities, coincidences. And I picked up a book. I think it was probably within 24 hours. And that book was all about gratitude. And this wasn't a new subject for me. Gratitude has always been, you know, part of my life. It's you know, even if you interviewed me 15 years ago, I wouldn't be talking about gratitude. But sometimes in life, we have to learn things to a much deeper level. We need to learn things from a totally new perspective. It's almost that for many years, I discovered the power of positive thinking. Positive mindset and how that attracts into your life all sorts of amazing benefits and synchronicities, coincidences. But it's almost like I had to experience the power of negative thinking, because I had become so negative simply because, you know, you can be knocked down gradually and lose your empowerment. No matter how empowered you feel, there can be circumstances that you experience later in life that can knock you down a lot. So the solution was this wonderful book about gratitude. And it was reminding me all about mindset. And I decided to do what today I call my crazy gratitude experiment. And I invite your watchers and your listeners to really, your viewers, to really test this for themselves. What I did was every 30 minutes of the day, I would check with myself what had been my most dominant thought and emotion during the previous 30 minutes. And each time I replaced it with gratitude. Now, you might think, what did I have to be grateful for? Things were pretty awful. And it was literally synthetic gratitude. The way I did this, I remembered a time in the past where I felt deep, sincere gratitude. I just remembered that event. I dwelled on it for a few minutes, and then, you know, you feel in the solar plexus area of the body sort of gratitude starting to bubble up. And it took a lot of effort at first, every 30 minutes of the day, remembering and really dwelling on that feeling. When I didn't want to feel it at all, I assure you. But after 24 hours, I didn't need to even remember a time in the past. I could actually spontaneously bring up this feeling. But the amazing thing is that within 3 days, incredible coincidences, incredible synchronicities that affect me to this day profoundly started happening. So it's almost like gratitude unlocked a door for me, a door that enables change to happen. I think when we're suffering deeply, it's like we're in a pitch black room, a completely dark room. We can't see anything in the room, but if we can imagine for a moment that there's a blinding white light on the other side of the door. Now, we can't see it because the door is closed, but all we need to do is open the door a crack and the light comes flooding in, and we can start to see our way forward. We can start to see our surroundings. We can start, you know, gratitude to me is a doorway to incredible wisdom. When we do this crazy gratitude experiment or just keep a gratitude journal, but make gratitude a dominant force in our lives, it allows us to operate at a higher conscious state. We have access to more wisdom. We feel very different. we are empowered. It's incredible. This simple thing, gratitude, it may sound all soft and wishy-washy and airy-fairy and very nice, but no, it's awesomely powerful. It can transform lives. And I'm absolutely sure of this from my own experience.
I love that. I love that story. It's so powerful. And, you know, here's the thing, because I know, you know, we live in a world today where, you know, money is definitely a big issue. And I want to kind of tie this into entrepreneurs and some of the problems that they're facing today. So either, you know, they're wanting to start a business or they have a business and they're having those, you know, ebbs and flows, and sometimes there's more ebbs than flows. So, so would you suggest in a person, you know, that is in that state right now, they're freaking out. I call it my freak out mode. So when I used to go into my freak out mode about money, my dominant thought pattern was worry, was crying, you know, poor me, getting into that victim mode. So how do you take someone out of that worrying state, like literally worrying about paying the electricity and the bills, to abundance, you know, with using some of the techniques and tools that you share about gratitude?
Oh, wonderful, wonderful question. And Heather, I experienced something exactly what you're saying. I experienced something about maybe 4 years ago. And basically we had a big credit card bill to pay for one of my companies. And there wasn't enough money coming in to cover it. And it was about 20 grand. It was a lot. And it was coming, it would be debited from our account later that morning. It was noon. And I thought, oh no, there was a shortfall of around 10,000. And those old feelings of panic from the time when I lost everything started to come up. Oh no, it's happening again. Oh no, no. It was almost paralyzing. But you know what? I saw where my mind was going and I chose differently. Immediately, within, I'd say 15, 20 seconds, I said, nope, I know this. And I started to bring up gratitude. I started to bring up trust, and everything will be fine. Something will happen. I'm absolutely confident. And I promise this happened. My cell phone rang. I got a call from a client who owed me about 15,000. And he said, Mike, I'm really sorry that I've taken so long to pay you this. But he said, I've just transferred the money into your account.
Wow.
And that was literally 30 seconds, 1 minute into doing this thing. Now you could look at it and you could say, oh yes, he'd transferred the money probably before I even did this technique. But, you know, I'm not so sure. I'm not so sure. Time and, you know, what do we know about time and intention? You know, I'm not so sure. But it was the best example of immediate effect. I've had a lot of other examples of things happening literally within minutes or hours of choosing a different mindset. And I think, like you said, a lot of people are struggling, especially if they're new to business. And there can be a huge amount of worry and fear over money. And that can exacerbate the whole situation. It can make it far, far worse. Now, I'm not saying ignore it or trust that everything will work out. No, no, no. What's so important is action. Action. You know, if we're just all overly trusting and we don't take the action, nothing really changes. It's so important to be very clear what we want, really clear, and then squeeze out of this thing between our ears the action steps we need to take to resolve our situation. And it's almost like the universe sees us and says, ah, somebody's making a lot of persistence here. I'll give this individual a little hand, you know. So when we work, the universe works, you know.
I love that. Yeah. So it's really about trusting and, of course, taking action, because you can't just, you know, wish for things to get better. You really do have to take action, you know, taking, even if I think sometimes if you don't know the action, the specific action, but as long as you're, you know, in motion, I believe, and I've seen for myself, things definitely happen. And, you know, let's talk about, you know, there in my notes, I have talking about Dr. Emoto's experiments with frozen water crystals. I actually remember watching the movie What the Bleep, but I was wondering if you could share your insights and what you know to be true about how the water crystals and our dominant thoughts are really linked together.
Oh, so much so. And I had proof of this. I really had proof of this several years ago. Lots of proof, but painful proof as well. Our dominant thoughts and emotions create the circumstances of our lives. I'm absolutely 100% sure of this. Our dominant thoughts and emotions create the circumstances of our lives. And the sad thing is, we are conditioned from the moment we're born, by society, by our parents, by our peers, by our school teachers, governments, religions. We are bombarded and conditioned to believe that we're not worth very much. And unless we start addressing those things, those areas of our lives, our subconscious beliefs create everything. So Dr. Emoto, Dr. Masaru Emoto, a Japanese doctor, I think he died last year, but he did an amazing experiment that proved that our thoughts and emotions actually affect physical matter. So this we need to really pay attention to this, because if science shows us that our thoughts and feelings affect what's around us, we need to pay attention to what we're actually transmitting out. So with Masaru Emoto, he was studying the crystallization effects of water. In other words, the formation of ice crystals in very cold water, freezing water. And he used high-speed photography in a very cold room. And basically, he got people to project thoughts, feelings, and even words to samples of water that were starting to freeze. And if the person, and this was completely scientifically based, in other words, repetition and checking the experiment and testing it again and again, coming up with the same results. What he found was that people who projected thoughts of anger, fear, all sorts of negative thoughts, the formation of the crystals was very stunted and quite ugly compared to people who projected feelings of gratitude, love, kindness, peace, and even using words, empowering words, as opposed to disempowering words, the type of crystals that would form would be completely different. And I think his book is it Hidden Secrets in Water? I think that's the name of the book. It shows these amazing crystal formations and the difference between negative and positive feelings and emotions. It's just incredible. Huge difference. So we need to be careful about what we're transmitting out. And our bodies are, 98% water? And there is a crystalline structure in our body. So we need to be careful. We're literally programming ourselves all of the time. And it's very hard to deprogram ourselves from all this conditioning, all this self-belief that's really negative. But there are ways to do it. There are very powerful ways to. Gratitude will help miracles, but also affirmations, using self-hypnosis, really potent. In fact, if you look at all, the most successful people in the world, most of them use self-hypnosis because they know that it's the most effective way to deprogram all this negative stuff we carry around with us, And
absolutely.
So ways we can do this.
And I was just thinking, you're talking about self-hypnosis, and I was thinking how powerful Muhammad Ali, who recently passed, he would do these things, I believe they're called quatrains, where he would basically psych his opponent out, It was amazing reading about him and just like his thought process and how he became the greatest, and it really ties into what you're talking about here.
Definitely. Well, from the time he was a young man, he kept saying, I am the greatest. I'm sure he was programming himself to become the greatest, and he became the greatest. In fact, I have a quote in my book from Muhammad Ali, and, literally, he used the power of affirmations. This repeating empowering statements to ourselves can change everything. We do this morning and evening. In fact, it's very simple to convert our goals. No matter what our goals are in life, we can convert them into empowering affirmations that we can read aloud. And we just need to watch and see what happens, because they're incredibly potent.
Absolutely. And I would also say, if you're, you know, doing affirmations, you also have to connect with the emotion, because what if someone's saying the affirmations and they're really not believing it, you know, then there's like a disconnect there.
Definitely. I mean, this is so true. When we do affirmations, we need to bring up a feeling as though it had already happened, excitement and yes, and also see it visually in our minds as clearly as we can. And then things really start to happen. If there's no emotion, if we're just going through a routine, a little like almost an empty ritual, nothing happens. Nothing really happens. And I think that The Secret, it was a wonderful book, wonderful movie, but there are so many missing secrets in The Secret. And this is one of the very important things, that we need to inject emotion into what we're doing. Because I often think it's a bit like a cell phone. If we have a cell phone and there's no battery, we can't speak to our next door neighbor. They're right beside us. But if we have a battery, a powerful battery, we can speak with anyone anywhere in the world. And this is what, for me, emotion is the connector to the universe. Emotion is what connects us to, it's our broadcasting station, you know?
Right. Absolutely. Yeah, I love that. And, you know, I wanted to talk about the importance of letting go or being detached from an outcome. So and I always like to bring it back to money, because I talk about money a lot and building your business, and especially as women, talking to women, they get emotional around money. So how do you deal with, or how would you help someone through, you know, just getting in their head, getting in their own way? You know, they're going through the process of affirming and gratitude, but yet there's that part of them that is still attached to the outcome of saying, wait a minute, I need money yesterday.
Sure. Well, I mean, when we're in a desperate situation, we're going to experience fear. And there's no way to completely eliminate fear. Fear has important benefits. You know, a friend of mine, a healer friend of mine years ago, he used to say that the acronym for fear is friendly energy announcing risk. Now, there's lots of acronyms for fear, but that's the only time I've ever heard that an acronym, friendly energy announcing risk. And I think it's a great an acronym, because that's what fear is. It's something that's warning us of a potential that might happen. But it can be totally paralyzing. It can destroy our lives. But you know, 99% of the time, what we fear doesn't actually happen. But knowing that intellectually, it doesn't really help. But doing these gratitude practices, this can help to, what would you say, melt the fear a little bit. And all we need to do, as I say, is open the door a crack and the light comes flooding in. All we need to do is shift our emotional state ever so slightly, and then things can start to happen. A writer who I know, a well-known writer years ago, once said to me, Mike, if you ever want to return to any state of consciousness you've ever experienced in the past, all you have to do is remember what it feels like. So that's why the gratitude experiment, crazy gratitude experiment, works. So it's not suppressing anything. It's not suppressing fear. It's definitely not that. But it's understanding that as human beings, we have amazing capacity to change our internal state if we choose to do so. Only if we choose to do so.
I love that. And there's a quote that William James, he was a famous psychologist, said that as human beings, we have the remarkable ability to change our perception. And that's really what you're talking about, is changing your perception, just for creating your own reality. And I'm so excited about this conversation, because I feel that this is going to help so many people that are listening and watching, and you know, they need that pick me up. They need to believe that there is something else out there, some kind of force, that if they just align their mind, their vision, their emotions, their thoughts to what they want and take action, then things will happen. And Mike, before we go, I know you've got a special gift here, and I want to give this, it's going to be in the show notes for those people tuning in. So if you go to unlockgratitudenow.com/gift, right, they can
absolutely
get your gift, and can you share a little bit about what that is?
Sure, sure. As you say, it's unlockgratitudenow.com/gift. And basically, I'm giving away a free copy of Unlock Gratitude Now. It's my bestseller on Amazon. It's a PDF version of it. And also an audiobook that I produced back in 2002 called What Happens When We Die. And I'm a real skeptic, but I have a passion, and that's researching life after death evidence. And I've been doing that for almost 40 years. So that's an audiobook I produced. It also can give people a lot of greater understanding about their true purpose here in this world. And when you understand why you're here, you get on with it and you make a difference in your life and others. And the other third part is a 4-part video course called 30 Days to Empowerment, Success and Happiness. So it's a book, an audiobook, and 4-part video course. And I think any of your viewers that try these things, I think it'll really help them.
I love that. And again, I encourage everyone to go over there. I'm going to give it again, unlockgratitudenow.com/gift. Well, Mike, it has been an absolute pleasure. Thank you so much for coming on to the show.
Anytime. Real pleasure. Thank you.
And I want to just thank all the listeners and watchers out there, and you are in the right place. You know, if you have a mission and purpose, you're on fire, you have to align your emotions and your thoughts and do not give up on yourself. You've got to believe in yourself more than anyone. So I just want to leave everyone with that thought. Until next time, this is Heather Picken. Take care.
I really do hope you've enjoyed this episode. And before I go, I have a very special offer for you, which I'll explain in a moment. But before I do, I just want to say that if you've enjoyed this episode, then please do give us a like below this video. Because when you do this, it enables other people to also benefit from it. Of course, if you'd like to leave a comment, then you're most welcome to do so. And I'd be really happy to hear from you. Now, if you're watching this episode on YouTube, please do remember to subscribe to my channel. And you can also listen to my Transformation and Empowerment podcast on iTunes. Now, let me tell you about the special gift I mentioned a moment ago. Because if you go to my website right now at transformandempower.com, then you can get immediate access to my special free gift. And I'm giving away a free report and audiobook that will help you to start achieving your life's biggest goals in the next 30 days. You'll also get my free video training course so you can break through everything that's been holding you back and finally experience the success and happiness that you deserve. So please visit transformandempower.com right now and pick up your free gifts. Once again, thanks so much for watching, and I look forward to serving you again soon.